They will destroy many people. They will destroy many Christians. Look at now today, the Christians don't want to pray anymore. They start worrying about the economies. They start worrying about the wars. Those all kind of things are kind of the destruction, the sickness. Look at now, my brother and sister. We've got now the sickness around the world. We've got the swine flu. We've got the economic crisis. We've got the wars across the world, my Lord. Oh, hallelujah. I'm telling you the truth. The Lord Jesus Christ is about to come. Those kind of things, it should come before the Messiah arrives, my brother. I'm telling you the truth. Don't worry about your business. Don't worry about your thing. Don't worry about your thing. You just focus on Lord Jesus Christ, because he said himself, I know you before you were born. In the book of Jeremiah chapter 1, in verse 3 to 4, he said that, I know you before you were born. You were somebody. Jesus Christ knows you. Jesus Christ knows you about to get the job. Jesus Christ knows about your churches. Jesus Christ knows about your ministry. Don't worry, my brother. Many churches today, they bring up the Antichrist into the churches without realizing they've already got the mark of the beast, but they don't realize the Lord said it's about to come. You pastor, if you know in your church there is the Antichrist, be ready to come out of it, because the Lord is coming. Don't worry about the economy. Don't worry about your family. Don't worry about your church members, because the Lord said his word made a man, his word created of things. Be prepared, my brothers and sisters. Be prepared. Get ready to change your life. Get ready to preach the truth. Get ready to do not the wrong things. Get ready to not to commit adultery in your ministry. Get ready to do the right things, because the Messiah is about to come. It's about to come. It's about to come. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Daniel prayed For long. Then the angel appeared to him. He said to him, Daniel, don't worry. The Lord is about to come. This is what is coming, is going to happen. I believe that chapter 32 is a real, my brothers and sisters. I saw that evening in my entire life. I took all the money out of my bank. I gave it to the ministry. I did it a big conference. I had nothing left in my money. I had nothing left in my bank. I said, no, the gospel must be preached across the world. The gospel must be preached. I took all the money out of my bank. Then we did the conference. Many people come up. Many people start praying. Many people start singing. Then after that, I start saying to myself, God, I sow the seed. I want to see the seed back is my mighty God. Hallelujah. It didn't even take me like all year. Within a year, I received more than what I spent. I believe that those who are trusting in the bank in the world, I believe that if the word of God said, where your treasure is where your heart will be. Then when the bank will be collapsed, you will lose all things. You will lose your faith. You will lose your family. You will lose your ministry. You will lose your country. You will lose your government. You will lose your community, because where your treasure was there. But when your treasure is in the Lord, because he's the rocks, because he's the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, you will not lose nothing. You will still stable. This is why the world doesn't understand that place. The world trusts in the world. The world trusts in the banks. The world trusts in the countries. The world trusts in the government. But the Messiah said, trust in him. He's going to restore you. He's going to give you more than what you did, more than what you think about your vision, about your studies, about your project. The Lord Jesus Christ is there. He cannot even do your homework. He can't even do your project. He can't even do your ministry. He can't even run all your country. He can't run all your entire business. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I feel something strange right now. Many people, many governments are destroying the money from out of the country, the Lord is about to tell you, you have to stop doing those kind of things. Not stealing the government's money. The Lord is about to tell you, it's about to come. You will see the vision. The Lord is about to tell you, it's about to warn you what now. Stop stealing the money out of the government. The Lord is about to tell you, it's about to come. It's about to pass in your entire life. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you be to God. Thank you be to God. Isaiah chapter 35 in verse 4, it says this. Say to them that are of a careful heart, be strong, fear not. Behold, your God will come with vengeance. When God with a recompense. He will come and he will save you. He will restore you. Don't worry, my brothers and sisters. Be strong. Behold. Be bold. Don't worry about the world. It's about to shake. Your family is about to shake. Your ministry is about to shake. There is not the church members in your church. The Lord is telling you what now. He said, the shepherd, hand everything into the Lord's hand. Don't worry about the missionary. Don't worry about that. Because the master is about to come. He said, the great shepherd, I'm about to tell you what now. If you are in cancer disease, if you are suffering from any sort of disease, if you are worrying, close your ears. Listen to the word of God. The Lord is there to lift you up. The Lord is there to come you up. The Lord is there to pull out of the bondages, out of the bad alliances. From evening your family, they say evening your family, you cannot get the marriage. You cannot get the jobs because you don't have the qualification, because you don't have this. The Lord is your shepherd. In Jesus Christ, he's there. He's there to save you out. It's there to save you. Look at me right now. I was dead. I was dead at 2 times, my brothers and sisters. I come out from a bad disease. Even in the cancer abdomen, I come out from it. Because why the Messiah is there to heal you the same way he delivered Israel out of Egypt, the same way the Messiah will deliver you out of the cancer, out of the bad oppression. You just trust on him. Walk in God's righteousness. The Lord is there for you, my brothers and sisters. He's going to give you the marriage. He's going to give you a good husband. He's going to give you a good wife. He's going to give you the qualification. He's going to give you the new vision. You will see the wonder. As long as you are walking in God's righteousness, don't rely on the world. Don't rely on the newspaper of the world, because it is destruction. It's the destruction. Trust on the Lord. Trust on the Lord, my brothers and sisters. You're the preachers. You have to preach the truth. I can see many churches today. They are not preaching the truth. They are doing their business. The Lord said that you cannot serve 2 masters. You have to serve 1 master. Just only God. Because in the book of Isaiah, the Lord said, beside him, there's no another God. Beside him, there's no death. Beside him, there's no disease. Beside God, there's no unemployed. Beside God, there's no the economic crisis. Beside God, there's no the bad prophet. Beside God, there's no the bad churches. Beside God, there's no worries. Beside him, there's nothing. Just honor him. Worship honor him. Because he's the Lord. He's about to come. Be prepared. Be repent. Hallelujah. 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 The Lord is good, my brothers and sisters. The Lord is good. Many preachers today, they can pull like the singers in the churches, not just because the Holy Ghost is there. They can pull them because of they know how to sing. They forgot the Holy Ghost can take the church service from the beginning to the end and more visions. Hallelujah. Many preachers today, many churches today, they are bringing the army from outside into the church's sanctuary, which is bad thing to do. Many people today, today that are going into the churches to commit the fornication, that adultery, to worship the idols. They pretend the Lord Jesus Christ is dead. This is why you can see many churches today. They cannot go over. People in the church are crying, "Where is the Lord Jesus Christ? Not working. Where is the Lord Jesus Christ?" Because the head of the church is, doesn't work in God's righteousness. When the fish is bad on top, the bottom was also bad. When your preach is not good, the bottom will be not good. This is why you can see you go to the church, you cannot receive the miracle, because there is not the truth. The church relies on the world. The church rely on the world. You have to come out of the world. You have to say to the people of God, this is how the Lord Jesus Christ is about to come, my brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. 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 I'm about to tell you what now, my brothers and sisters, like in the book of Daniel chapter 11 and in verse 32. He said that those who will trust in God, they will be exploited. Those who will trust in God will be exploited. I'm telling you the truth. Do you trust in the Lord? That's my question to you. Do you trust in the Lord? Do you walk in God's righteousness? If you do, but why you keep on worrying a lot? My brothers and sisters, why you keep on worrying a lot in your entire life about husband, wife, about your education, about your ministry? Why you are worrying a lot? You have to look around you. Many pastors today, they cannot love one of them. Many evangelists today, they don't love another evangelist. Many prophets today, they don't love another prophet. Hate in the world, my brothers and sisters, hate in the world, hate in the world. And you can say this prayer with me: Lord Jesus Christ, I trust in you. In Jesus' name, I give you my life. I want my life to change. In Jesus' mighty name, hallelujah, amen, amen.
Assembly of God of Glory, Manchester Brown. She's proud to invite you to this 5-day conference, The Time of Visitation 2009. The conference will be packed with highly anointed men of God. Apostle Ngombo, founder of International Assembly of God of Glory. Guest speaker, Bishop.